am on my way to Cades Cove. It is a 11-mile scenic loop. If you notice, I have the track camper off. I just said in a few videos, not just a few videos back, that the only time I usually take it off is when I need to do truck maintenance or something. Well, this isn't the case, which is a good thing. My truck seems to be doing really good. But my sister-in-law said that it was a very narrow roadway. So I talked to a ranger, and he said that, I asked him about a truck camper RVs, and he said RVs, if it's a big RV, he wouldn't suggest it, but probably a truck camper would be fine. But I decided to go ahead and take it off because I'm going to go do some other hiking. Some of the trailheads start on these narrow roads, so I figured that I would have a better chance of finding a parking place, which is hard to find, with just the truck and not the truck camper. So, while the truck camper is off, I'm gonna go do some hiking, but I'm gonna go do this 11-mile loop, and they say that you should allow for the 2 to 3 hours to do this. So that's what I'm gonna do. It's 9:30. Plus it's an hour drive from the campground to there. It's only 19 miles, but it's long and curvy 30 mile an hour roads. So anyway, I wanna get started and take you along with me. Is that a turkey? I would say so. Okay, to the left of that big tree, right there, is a bear. I know you probably won't be able to see it. Well, this is a short building. I just hiked up this mountain. It's a half a mile up where this cabin is. I'm out of breath. Let's go through here. This is a big climb up here. Boy, you wonder about these these boards. You can't see. Okay, maybe that's better. Not really. I guess these are the stables. Can't go in that one. You can go in this one. Wow. Amazing. It's amazing how they built. No nails. It's just like a triangle. A curve on the bottom and a triangle on top. Pretty cool. Round on the bottom, triangle on top. All right, let's go back down the hill. Interesting. Did several of the buildings here in Cades Cove and decided to do the Abrams Trail hike to the falls. So that's going to cut my rest of the scenic tour short because I've walked over 6 miles because it was a half a mile to that one building, and then Abrams Falls was 5 mile hike, 2.5 in and 2.5 out. So that's gonna cut the rest of this drive short because I don't want to walk anymore. I'm tired. So we'll just do some of the drive. Well, I can't ever say that I haven't seen a bear now. I remember telling Dan that I had not seen a bear, and he was surprised. So, I've seen a bear two up close and personal. This is Dan Lawson's place. Something happened there, not sure what. So, they say 3 to 4 hours for the hike, and 2 to 3 for the scenic drive. So, you could do a very long day of this or break it up in 2 days, and if you want to see all of it, because it's just hard to do Cades Cove scenic loop drive and the hike. Now back to the scenery. The trees are turning. Well, they're turning. They're getting leaves. Isn't that pretty? Pretty red. Log cabin. Oh, this is Tipton's place. that's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool house right there. There's their barn.